5 more to go. And up next will be National Featherweight Challenge, 8 rounds, Kazim Belight Oliwo up against Tope TP Rock Musa.
In 2018, a total of 5.320 trillion naira was collected as taxes by the Federal Inland Revenue Service, FIRS. This is the highest ever collected as federal taxes in Nigeria. Taxes have become an important source of revenue, enabling the government to provide greater infrastructural developments in our country. Tax revenues enable government to provide more roads, more railways, more bridges, more housing, more schools, more students in schools, more hospitals, more security, and generate more power. Because Nigeria deserves more. Only your taxes can make all our dreams come true. This message is from the Federal Inland Revenue Service, FIRS. It pays to pay your tax.
Well, we're waiting the fifth bout of the night to take center stage. That fifth bout will be a National Featherweight Challenge context. I'm going to have 8 rounds of boxing. Kazim Delight Oliwo against TP Rock Musa. Now, TP Rock, every time he steps into the rope square, he brings something new. Fantastic boxer. But I will see what he's got against Oliwo tonight. Oliwo will have to be really on top of his game. He's got the light. Can he shine his light in the ring here in the indoor hall of the National Stadium in Surulere, Lagos? A place that has seen so many superb fights take place. Can two of them bring it on to the fans? Because we have seen 4 already. Classic fights here.
Oh, the 4 bouts we've seen tonight have all been explosive. And really, let's go into the ring now. The 5th bout, it's almost ready. And let's bring in the 2 boxers into the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, our 5th fight for the night is an 8-round National Featherweight Challenge bout. In the blue corner, Kazim the Light Oliwo.
The Light Oliwo. Kazim. And this man has got a whole lot to prove tonight when he takes on TP Rock Musa.
He's coming with a very calm demeanor. You know, boxers with that different stuff. We saw the ice star coming like a house on fire earlier on and bringing it on as well. And we also saw the 2 ladies from Always Boxing Club, Rodiat, the princess, as well as a contemporary, if we can use that word for her, talking about the Bobby girl, also Ogusha Milore, are coming in very explosively. But for Delight, it's calm, cool, and collected.
Definitely, it was a great first round TKO for Cynthia. Congratulations to her. Back into the ring now.
In the red corner, Tope TP Rock Musa.
Thank you.
In the blue corner, he weighed in at 57 kilograms. He has had one fight, lost one. Kazim, the light, Oliwo.
Quite inexperienced compared to TP Rock.
In the red corner, he weighed in at 58.3 kilograms. He has had five fights, won four, lost one, won four via knockout. Tokwe, TP Rock Musa. Our judges are Constance Chinagorum, Wahab Martins. Latif Muiz, and our referee is Shegu Adesanya.
I expect you to give me a clean fight, obey my command at all times. I want clean fight. Do not eat below the belt or above the head. Rabbit punching. Your 2 seconds allowed to throw in the towel if the need be. No gloves now and at the beginning of the last one.
And we're ready for this one. And interestingly, my man and I, Ralph Chidoze George, just got greeted by one of the greats of Nigerian boxing. Talking about the one they call Jerry Boy, Jeremiah Korodudu. It's good to see a legendary boxers like that here on the Gold TV Boxing Map.
Korodudu in the house to see these two boxers. I hope they impressed him. Oliwo in white and green. And TP Rock in white, red, and of course, black.
Boxers trying to give them size themselves out with some body punches there.
Oliwo, his second professional fight, lost the very first one he had.
Interesting thing, both boxers have actually tasted the bitter peel of defeat. In five, TP Rock won four, all four by knockout, but also lost one as well. So they know what it is to lose a bout.
And he's been clamoring for the national title. He's hoping that one day, soon, very soon, he's going to get a chance to fight for the title. And that's TP Rock.
Good combinations there. Oh, catches Oliwo there. That was very, very bad of Oliwo. He's not even protecting himself very well there.
What's he doing?
I wonder what he was thinking about. Good body punches there. Massive body punches there.
All right, now, I don't understand what he's doing. He has come here to take punches.
I mean, what was that about? Protecting one side of the jaw and leaving the other one that was actually closer to your opponent.
Body shots are going good, left good from him.
I think TP's looking to systematically break down his opponent, tie him up, and then look for the drop gloves and then take him out. Look at that combination. Two to the body, two to the top as well. In the ring, rather it is a titular takeoff.
there telling him what that was where we were talking about earlier. And they look at where he's covering up, and then he leaves the open side, which is actually closer to the opening. Leaves it off.
I don't want to do the time. What? Thank you.
Second round.
Box.
Referee says box for two boxers. 8 rounds of boxing. This is only the second round. The light really have to do a lot. Because I need, he needs to improve on his footwork. He's not putting anything into that footwork at all. And those are recipes of you getting tired early. Good body shot from TP Rock. You see the combination, very quick combinations coming from TP Rock, and the good fight back there coming from Palat.
He sends 1-2 to the body and goes through the head too.
Very methodical, talking about TP Rock.
Very. The Luo finding it difficult to penetrate TP Rock. Luo just senses that I can do this.
Yeah, and I'm starting getting more and more confident. But I'm still not very impressed with his style of boxing.
Sluggish,
very sluggish. Look at that, look at those combinations. And he was able to break it there with that right hook there, talking about TP Rock. He's not going to, Luo's not going to hurt TP Rock the way he's going. If you look at those combinations once again. Tries to use the body punch. To open up Oliwo, and so far so good, he's working.
Oh, good straight left.
He's cut, once again, he's got his upper leg. Can he finish it up here? I think TP Rock senses that he's got this fight under control, and it's just a matter of time before he dismantles his upper leg. Again, those left and right combinations.
When TP Rock needs to be more precise too. Body shot there.
He's missing a whole lot of headshots. There you have it again. I wonder what Oliver is looking at. I mean, he's meant to be a delight to the fans, but he's not get anything close to that.
Look at body shot.
This combination to be rock. Absolute delight to watch. He should be delight.
End of the second round of this Shadow 8.
Like you said earlier, I think TP Rock needs to be more accurate. If he were to be more accurate, at least a bit more accurate than what he was, I think he would have taken out his opponent by now. And then look at it again. He opens the man up, but he's not able to follow it up properly. Round three on the way here, out of a possible eight. That's if he goes the whole distance. And it is a national featherweight challenge. Palat in white trunks there with some green trimmings, while we've got TP Rock, Tope Musa,
also in white trunks with a black and red trim.
Delighted also, he's got some vision going very well. Regarding that, big body shot coming from him.
And that's the thing there, TP Rock seems to be encouraging him. He's been the man in dominant position in the past two rounds. But then of course, if you can't take out your opponent, sooner or later, your opponent will send some get some confidence. And he's trying to come back in, but I'm not particularly impressed. His footwork is not sound. His punching style looks a bit too, you know, off.
Yeah, TP Rock has to do the job. They have him.
Look at that recovery
combination there from
those
him.
Combinations are crazy. Good punch there coming back. Once again, look at that. Opens him up with a body punch and connects with a right hook to the left of the face. Look at that. Very methodical.
This one got one going there.
And he will not just go away. Every time he gets punched, he still keeps going forward. That must be his motive, moving forward. He showed at the beginning of that round, or this round rather, can pay off for him, because he looked for a business like, didn't even stay that long in his corner. Well, he's gonna have to take a risk if he wants to take this man out. Sudden, the light seems to be finding some combinations.
You know, he extremely struggles to throw the punches. He could notice that it takes seconds for his hand to travel to his opponent. So,
hey, break.
Because for a break,
not allowed. Box.
It's not allowed. It's also light.
But I'm a bit impressed with what Liwa has been able to do. He knows his opponent. He's got fantastic hand speed, so he's making sure at all times he's got his hands in the middle of both of them. That's something about you.
So speedy hand, fine, but you need to be precise
about it.
seen Tipi Rock fight a couple of times. I never thought this bout to go this distance.
Especially with what you saw in the first round.
Exactly.
But I think, like I said, I think he needs to do a lot more. He's fighting a man who's got a very strong jaw. And he's not going to go unless you really bring up your own A game. Look at that, he catches him. I would expect him to follow up right now. If you see that, he's wobbly. He's wobbly. Can he finish it up? Oliwo protecting himself again. At this point in time, he shouldn't be allowing Oliwo to come back into it. But then sometimes you also have to preserve your energy because you could throw everything and the boxer does still not go out. And you might have fizzled yourself.
Big body shot there. That one, it got him there.
And that's why I said he needs to concentrate more on the body punches. I have seen a lot of boxers go down because of body punches.
Tipi Rock, he should know when his man is in trouble, his opponent is in trouble, and go for the kill.
Yeah, totally.
He doesn't have that big punch.
Yeah, he doesn't have the killer punch, but he's got the stinging ones. I mean, the man is in trouble right there again, but he's allowing him to come back into it.
Oliwo is struggling.
I would expect to see a lot more body punches. I keep saying now, that is the secret to winning this fight.
To the fifth round of the scheduled eight. National Featherweight Challenge contest has seen the light of Oliwo. And that white and green talk by Tipi Rock, really rocking.
Tipi Rock to take keeps coming. That's because Stevie Ward always allows him to come in. I think he's contented. He just wants to get the victory by any means necessary. It doesn't have to be by a knockout. But if you look at his antecedents, five fights, four wins, four knockouts, you'd think he is the knockout specialist.
And Oliwo is still there. And I'm really disappointed by TP Rock tonight. He knowing his opponent, just one fight and one loss in his career, you should have expected him to take him out.
Absolutely. But sometimes you might have just come up short in your first and only fight. He's obviously showing that he's a very strong fighter. Talking about the line, it's going to take a whole lot.
He's not been following
to the canvas.
He gets the man a bit in trouble, and he needs to apply the pressure more.
I mean, we keep seeing the flashes every round. I mean, him connecting.
Scheduled 8,
and looks like we're gonna have the second fight. We just might have the second fight that's gonna go the distance. We saw one earlier, and it was a total cracker. Adeyemi Spirit, Adekunle, getting the decision over Isaac Istar Chukwudi.
Very close contest. What confidence can do to a man.
All of a sudden, TP Rock is the man on the defensive. But I sense a strategy on the part of TP Rock. I think he's actually intentionally luring his opponent, probably trying to exhaust him, and then maybe going for the kill in the last of the 3 minutes in the round. But he's tried all tricks that he's got in the books, and they haven't worked efficiently against this man. He doesn't look like a studio's boxer. He looks more like a brawler. There you are. Every time TP Rock has landed a body punch, he tells more. Why can't he just focus on that and keep up with it?
Liu himself, I'm showing like great evasions there.
There you go again. There you go. He's connected with the counter. I mean, he's got his man right there again, but he keeps backing off. He's going to have to be bold. You're just going to have to be bold and get in there. That's it. And you just have to give it to Oliwo. He's taking a whole lot of battering here, but he's still holding his head up high.
As you can see, he's looking a bit jagged, a bit tired there.
I talked about this earlier, that this could be the style or the strategy that Adekunle is actually hoping to use. But every time he's had his man, he's let him off again.
Break, break.
Referee says break. Hey. So he has noticed some bleeding.
Hello.
That's a good job. That's a sign that you're doing the job. Talking about
Adekunle
straight in the nose. So
Adekunle has taken some beating here tonight, but it keeps going. Keeps coming, saying, "No, I won't take it."
Could this be the sign that TP Rock needs? Is that the blood he needs to smell?
Box.
I can continue.
But I think he's going to survive again, talking about Delight. It's almost the end of the sixth round here. And he's bringing in the style now. That was a lucky escape for him.
sure this will set him back a whole lot.
This minute, the next minute, he's looking good body punch there. And there you have it. It is going to go the distance.
We have one more round to go in the fifth fight of the night.
Oh, good, yeah.
We're definitely going to see a unanimous decision here. But I believe with the intensity dropping inside the indoor sports hall here, it's obvious that the fans were looking forward to something more explosive after five explosive bouts of boxing. And all of a sudden, I just mentioned that now, they seem to have awoken again. The light looking to finish strong here. Gets caught there. Oh, gets caught again. Good counter punching coming from TP Rock. But then every time he punches this, gets into that range that he needs to find himself. You see the light always stepping forward again.
TP Rock, I just looking to see how can I deliver that killer point on this opponent.
That would be the lovely icing on the cake for him.
All he needs to do now is just dance around as he's doing at the moment. Dance around. He knows he's got this one in the bag. Dance around. Got his man there. Good combination from TP Rock. Wide swing from TP Rock.
Another wide swing again, but he gets him finally. He's just a stubborn man, he wouldn't go away. Good right there, catching the light on the side of the...
Hey, break. Use of break.
You know, fighters box. Like a delight for me.
Good combination once again.
Break. Box.
Referee has a delight to it. Bring the face off.
Good counter punch in there. But once again, the light dances out of it. Four different combinations there. And he gets himself out of it. He's an awkward fighter. An absolutely awkward fighter. And now see him getting TP Rock in a very difficult situation. That's the punch there. Good connection coming from the light. Look at that again, he fights back, keeps fighting back every time. I think we're probably not giving him a whole lot of kudos as much as we should give him.
We need to congratulate the Light for going the distance against this opponent on TP Rock. All 8 rounds in his back. It's been a great time for him.
Combinations there, but in the end, the combinations didn't really affect her. The light there. But to be honest, Tippy Rock needs to do more in terms of the accuracy of his punches. He's got the combination. And you can see him locking it up there. Yes, you can be happy about the decision, but the camp needs to worry about the fact that if he was a better boxer, Tippy Rock could have found himself in deep trouble.
Alright, now, about time to get the official decision. Into the ring now for the official decision of this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the results. Judge Constance Chinagorum scores it 72-80. Judge Abdul Wahab Martins scores it 74-80. Judge Latif Muiz scores it 72-80. The winner by unanimous decision, Tope T.P. Rock!
And T.P. Rock wins it. Tope Musa, winner by unanimous decision as expected. Everyone expected him to have taken his opponent down, but it didn't have that big punch to do that. And the fight went the distance. Unanimous decision. Everyone saw that coming. For boxers like Oliwo